My name is Romarez Moody, and I serve as the associate pastor of our Young Adults and Compassion Ministries at Harvest Bible Chapel. I grew up going to church with my mom every Sunday. I remember knowing the basics, knowing that you had to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. I felt that I had done that, but I just wasn't yielding fruit in it. When I was about 15 or 16, my parents' marriage fell apart. And they ended up getting a divorce. I decided to go and live with my dad so I wouldn't have to go to church. And I began to hang out with people that I shouldn't have been hanging out with. They introduced me to marijuana. And I began smoking marijuana more and more. And then it turned into smoking and selling marijuana. My life started to spiral out of control. I remember one Sunday, my mom picking me up for church. And at this time, I was only going to church on Easter. And I remember at the end of one particular service, her shoving me saying, "Ramirez, go to the altar for prayer. You need prayer, son." And so I went to the altar and I asked the person to pray that God bring someone into my life that will bring me closer to Him.
We met on a blind date some 20 years ago. On the surface, Ramirez was like everything I was looking for. He was handsome, tall, successful. We were a great match. We embarked on this new life together as a married couple.
Here it is. God has blessed me with a career, blessed me with the woman of my dreams, but I still had this thing that I was holding on to, and that was a secret sin of drugs.
On the outside, everything looked great, but you always feel like that something's not right. And I never knew what it was. So I would pray and just say, "Lord, what's wrong?" Just trusting and believing that, you know, it would come out one day.
I remember getting caught with drugs more and more, so much so to the point where I would end up in front of the same judge every time. And I remember the judge saying, "Ramirez, if you get caught one more time, you're gonna have to do some time." And so I thought that that was God's will for my life, that He was gonna allow me to go to jail in order for me to be set free from this. So one day, I'm in Chicago. I decided to pull over to smoke. And there was a police truck that pulled up right next to my truck. He gets out of the truck and he's walking across the front of my car and he's saying, "I see you, I see what you're doing, get out of the car." But he wasn't really concerned about the drugs. He comes up to me and he puts his hand on my shoulder and he said, "Son, what are you doing? You need to stop listening to this music you're listening to. You need to stop doing these drugs. You need to start listening to Moody Bible Radio. You need to start listening to K-Love." And I remember immediately crying. I just broke down and lost it. I know it was at that moment that I was set free from the addiction. I should have gone to jail. I would have lost everything. Just seeing His kindness towards me let me know that that was the Lord.
When it started to come out, then it started to make sense. That was painful to think that, you know, you're in a relationship with someone that you think you know them, and now you find out things that you weren't prepared for.
I started listening to Moody Bible Radio, and there was one particular pastor said that I would encourage you to find a Bible teaching church. And so me and my wife went on that pilgrimage. When we walked into the doors of the church that God would have us to be at, we knew that that was our home. And it just took off from there.
It was good for me to see Ramirez developing in the church, but it was also good for our marriage because I could see him growing and then our marriage growing as well as God got back into the center of our marriage.
This particular church had a Bible school. I enrolled in the Bible school. And at the same time, the pastor had noticed something in me and began to train me up to become a pastor. And it was in this process that we discovered Harvest Bible Chapel. And I remember they shared with me that they were interested in me coming on staff, and we decided to make the decision to come to Harvest Bible Chapel, and it was the best decision that we could have made.
We've now been at Harvest about 3 years, and it has been amazing to watch God working in our lives. Every day, every week, I see how God has opened doors, has made ways out of where there was no way, where there was no path. So I'm just so thankful that we have God in our lives, that God loves us, and we're just so blessed to be at Harvest. We now have a new family.
From the very first page through the very last, the Bible seems to demonstrate one relentless passion. That is the Father's passion to see those whom He has created to walk in intimacy with Him. In Jeremiah chapter 31, verse 3, the Lord speaks to the people of Israel saying, "I have loved you with an everlasting love, and I have drawn you in loving kindness." This voice is so beautiful, not only because it reveals the depth of the Father's love towards us, but also because it demonstrates God's passion to draw us onto His presence.